Okay. Good morning. Today is Friday. It is the 11th day of Kislev. We have today actually a very a difficult chapter in the Tanya, Kabbalistic terms. And again, just to try to simplify as much as possible, in general, in this part of the Tanya, the Kuntres Achren, the Rebbe here begins explaining the idea. So why the Arizal says that today we are doing the refining of the godly sparks through mainly through prayers. And what that means, in short, as we explained in previous lessons, there is everything in the world has light and a vessel. And you have intellect, you have the brain that contains the intellect. Everything has a light and a vessel. And when Hashem first created the world, it says that the Medrash says that there was a world that was created and that it was shattered, which means that there was a lot of light, but there was no vessels. The vessels were not capable to hold the light. I mean, you can use an example. Think of an example of a person has some great news that he received, very, very news that can affect the person greatly. We know, for example, it says by Yaakov Avinu, when Yosef was gone for so long, and he thought he was dead. And finally, the brothers came the time to reveal to the father that he's alive. So they didn't want to tell him right away. Why not? Because if they tell him right away, it could be that his vessel, the body, could not contain so much. It's a danger. When you want to give news that is overwhelming, then the body cannot contain it. So that's why they didn't tell him right away. They sent Serach, his granddaughter, all what the Medrash tells us. So here we're talking about the light of Hashem, the energy that was so powerful that the world could not contain it. And for that reason, the vessel shattered and the godly sparks fell into places, into low places. And our job is to elevate it. Our job is to refine it. How? When we use, there's three different ways. Through mitzvahs, when you do mitzvahs, through study the Torah, and through prayer. So in here, he talked about the prayer, and then he talked about the actual halachas, the mitzvahs that pertain the actual deeds of Hashem. And the halachas are the laws that tells you exactly how to perform the mitzvahs. And to give you one introduction also to what he's talking in today's Tanya, we know we have different worlds, as we explained in previous lessons, the world of Atzilus, Bria, Yetzira, and Asiya, which each world has more and more revelation of godliness. Atzilus has the ultimate revelation of godliness. Now, within each world, there is also what is called the Nefesh, Ruach, Neshama. Besides the fact that each world has 10 attributes, the emotional attributes and the intellectual attributes, Chochma bin Adas is the intellectual attributes. You have Chesed, Gvura, Tiferes, Netzachod, Yesod, and Malchus is the emotional attributes. In addition to that, we have also each level is divided to three, which is Nefesh, Ruach, and Neshama. What that is? These are just like in the soul of a person. It says every soul has five parts. Two parts, Chaya Yechida, this is the holiest part. This is not even to talk about, is the part that is connected with Hashem. But the three lower parts, Nefesh, Ruach, and Neshama, so the Nefesh Ruach is more connected with the emotion and the action. But Neshama is connected to the holiness of the of this. They're connected to something which is above you, the intellect. You can reach with the intellect something which is higher than where you are. So here it comes and says also that in this, each world also has the Nefesh Ruach and the Neshama. So he's going to explain that there are things in this world which is in a higher part of this world, but yet they're connected, yet they're limited. Why? Because they are the source of the actual physical world. But when you're talking about the halachas, the laws of God's Torah, they are connected with the neshama part. And therefore, they come down to this world to illuminate, to bring the light of Hashem, not as the source of the actual, the physical creation per se, but is the one that comes to refine and to elevate this physical world. So again, like we said, it is a little complicated and difficult, but let's see and try to understand as much as possible. Says the Alter Rebbe, Ve'atam, and the reason why it says that you have the difference between the light that comes through the level of neshama and the part which is comes to the halacha is higher than the part of the godliness that makes the world to exist. Because the Chabad, the intellectual Chachma Binadas of Asiya, of the level of Neshama, Chayus the Chabad the Nefesh Veruach. This is the source of the life of Chabad of the lower levels, Nefesh and Ruach. And the offsprings and their coming into being, the ex nihilo, something from nothing, with their offsprings unto the ultimate stage of the Asiya, namely the earth and all its hosts. So this is part of the creation. Aval but Chachma bin Adas, the halachis v'tameyin. We're talking about the Chachma bin Adas of the laws and the reasoning of the laws. Shebe Malchus, the Briye v'yitzira. They are in the level of Malchus, which is the lowest level of the world of Briye and Yitzira. Nevertheless, they're higher, even though they come from the lowest level. It explains, Inyan ha-Chachma yibetikun patzufa yatzilis. The function of Chachma within them is the rectification of the partzufim, the attributes of Atzilus. Shebahem tluim kol taimi amitzvus, upon which are dependent all the rationales of the commandments. In the world of Atzilus, in the attributes of Atzilus, they are godliness, and within them you have the chesed, the kindness, and you have the gevura, the strictness, and they are the source of the reasoning of the laws of the Torah. So you have mitzvahs asay behei chasadim. You have the positive commandments when Hashem tells us to do positive things. This, the root of their of these positive commandments is the five attributes of chesed, of kindness. Mitzvahs loisa asay. And you have the commandments that are negative commands and the prohibitions, they are rooted in Hei Gevuris, in the five attributes of severity. And this is why, even when they come down to be clothed in the created beings, meaning the laws of the Torah comes down into tefillin, comes down into physical objects. So it comes down, nevertheless, they still remain godly. Hein b'malchus lebriya v'yitzira debchinas neshama davke, shehu mikelim de'atzilus. They are in the malchus of bria yitzira, but the specific godly state of neshama, it is in the godly part of it. And this is from the kelim, the vessels of atzilus. Veloi b'prinas nefesh ruach. And it's not in the level of nefesh and ruach. And it continues the Alter Rebbe now, as we said before, this part of the Tanya, the Kuntres Achren, comes also, the Alter Rebbe, it is the sons of the Alter Rebbe took this from the notes that he found, the addendums, and he covers different questions that they find. People who study the Kabbalah, they find some things that seem to be contradicting to what he says here, and he comes and he explains it, that there's no contradiction. So one of the contradictions that he found, he says, "Af de chabad de bria yitzira de b'chinas neshama." Even though the levels of chachma binadas of bria yitzira from the level of neshama, as we explained earlier, shegova ma'oid ma'alosan al b'chinas malchus de bria yitzira de neshama, they are certainly higher, great much higher than the level of malchus of bria yitzira of this level of neshama b'yisrael. Ve'af al pikein, ein moker lechabad bria yitzira shel b'chinas nefesh ruach she'ein emalachim. Nevertheless, we say that they are the source of the chabad of bria yitzira of the level of nefesh and ruach, which is the malachim, the angels. What is he saying? He's saying that there seems to be, how do we then say that the malchus bri yitzira of the state of neshama cannot descend to become a source of created being when chabad of bria and yitzira of the state of neshama that is far loftier than malchus does serve as a source for created being? So he's saying it seems to be contradicting. One place it says that the malachim are connected with the level of nefesh and ruach, which is the lower ones. And yet here it says that the source of it is the chabad of the neshama. So this is going to answer that there's no contradiction. I mean, just like when you say we're talking about birth, a birth of a child. So the child, where does the child come from? It comes from the, as Alter Rebbe says in the beginning of Tanya, it comes from the brain of the father. But it comes from the brain of the father. Is he the father or is he a separate being? Obviously, he's a separate being. But even though everything can be exactly the same, but it's a separate being. And this is because there is a process of how the child comes to be when it goes through the 9 months in the womb and so on and so forth, comes from the brain, goes through the spine and so on and so forth, and the development. So the same thing is going to say, the same thing is from the Malachim. Yes, it is true that the source, the root is in the Neshama of Chachma bin Adas, in the level of Neshama, but yet it went through the process being born, so to speak. And that went through the Sprasher. That's what the Alter Rebbe is explaining now. He says, Loi kashamide, this is not a question at all. The Be'emes, because the truth is, Amalachim, Amalashama is, Einon Elomiat Mitipo, Anim Sheches, Mechachma Binadas, the Neshama. They, the Malachim, the angels, and the Neshamas, they come from the drop that is drawn down from Chachma Binadas of the neshama, liyesoidezo, and they go to the attribute of yesod, of zo, venitena nukven, and this is transmitted to nukva, which is the feminine, which is malchus, umisham yatsu vibchinas leida. And from there, the souls and the angels went forth in a state of birth. So now it becomes a new entity. So he says, even if it is if it is proposed that they are created from the radiance of the vessels of Nukva Vatzilus. Nevertheless, they themselves descend into Bria and Yetzira and Asiya and become Neshama unto them. So this, we're talking about the Malachim, we're talking about the Neshamas. But the very essence of Chabad, of Chachma bin Adas, which is the wisdom of Hashem, that comes down in the Torah. Aval Atzmus, Chabad, the Neshama, Mispashet, Bevov, Ktzovois, Bezun. The essence of Chabad, the Chachma bin Adas, of Neshama, extend into the six directions of Zun. The six directions mean cover all sides, in the top and the bottom, of Zun, Zov, and Nukva. Vesham, Heim, Shisha, Sidre, Mishnah, Vegimara. And there, they are the six orders of the Mishnah. You know, the Mishnah that we study has the six Shisha Sidarim, the six parts to it, the six orders, and the Gemara, and the laws of the Torah. So the bottom line, again, like we said in the beginning, this is a very Kabbalistic and complicated concept that is talking here. But the main thing is, what we're saying, is that the Alter Rebbe says that there is two ways of things to being clothed. There is things that come clothed and it's covered and you don't see it. And there's things that comes, but it's there. There's very essence of from where it comes is revealed in the bottom. Take, for example, if you have a sun shining in the room, very strong, and you want to reduce the sun, it's too strong. There's two ways of doing it. One way, you can put up a curtain. If the curtain is not enough, you can put up another curtain, and then the light that comes through the curtain, it changes, becomes like a different light, a more reduced light. But then there's another way of reducing the light is when you have, let's say you close up the window, and you block up the window, but you leave a tiny, tiny hole for light to come in. There, the light is a smaller light, but it still comes in the same light of the sun. It's not a different type of light. So when we're talking about the godliness that comes down to the world, there is the godliness that is the source of the creation of this world. This is godliness that comes in a way of concealment. But the godliness that comes through the will of Hashem, which is through the Torah and through the mitzvahs, this is godliness that is not concealed. Yes, it is dressed in garments, and you don't, like the laws of the Torah, it talks about physical objects. So it is clothed in these garments, but yet they carry in them the very essence and the very light of Hashem. And through doing this mitzvah, and through doing the Torah and davening, we bring out the essence of the neshama and bring this to revelation. So this is the end of today's shiur. Mizrat Hashem, we'll see you on Sunday morning, 9:00. Thank you so much for joining. And please, once again, share. We're getting closer and closer to Yutes Kislev, which is going to be a week from this Shabbos. So Yutes Kislev, the Chag HaGeulah, is the day when we're going to start Tanya again. So we're going to encourage more and more people to join and to listen to this Tanya lessons. A good Shabbos. Any questions?